Hi everyone, welcome to Naresh IT. This is Sai. Once again, come back to our session here. Establishing connection with driver to the database, performing database transactions using driver, closing connection with the driver to the database. If you see these operations here, in order to perform a communication, Java application with the database here, how to load this driver actually, how to register the driver with the driver manager actually, that we are going to see one simple example here. So if we observe class dot for name statement, how it was loaded, you can see class, I have a simple class A. In this class I have one static block, System.out.println of A static block, class B static block, System.out.println of B static block. So we have two different classes, A, B. So these both classes contain static block. Now class test, public static main, string argument type of array. Now see class dot for name of args of 0. So here we are going to pass the class name from the command line, args of 0. In the 0th index position, whatever the class name we passed, that we are going to pass as an argument to the class dot for name statement. So command line arguments you already know in your core Java concept. So now let's see here how this program will execute with a simple program. Under the C drive, I am going to create one new folder, JDBC Sai, saving the program as a1.java. Now compiling my application, cd space java c space a1.java. So whenever at the time of compiling this program, here I am getting the error as unreported exception, class not found exception, must be caught or declared to be thrown. So the exception class dot for name is coming from this statement here, class not found exception. So here we need to understand one simple point, the class dot for name may be the sense of throwing the exception, class not found. So if you are interested to handle this exception, you can supply try catch block, or if you are not interested to handle this exception, you can simply say the statement throws exception here. So you know throws exception means whatever the exception which was occurred, we are going to forward those exceptions to the JVM. Why? Because JVM is a caller for main method. JVM is a caller for main method. So what are the exceptions which are thrown from the main method? Caller is responsible to handle that exception. So you can give either try catch block or you can use this throws, because I am sure this exception cannot occur at runtime. So that's why I am not interested to handle this exception by using try catch block. Simply I am forwarding this exception to my JVM in case if it is occurred at runtime. Now compiling the program once again. So program is compiled successfully. Now Java space my class test space A. So Java space test my class A. So whatever the class name we passed here, this is command line argument. So what the JVM will do before calling the main method from this class? Before calling the main method from this class, JVM finds for the given number of command line arguments. So how many arguments we passed here? Only one we passed. So internally JVM creates an array for the string type. That array size is 1 because you supplied only one command line argument. So array size is 1 means in the 0th index position your class name, your value A is stored. Finally, that string array address is passed as an argument to the main method belongs to the class test. So if you run right now here, A static block. So whatever the class name we passed right now from the command line, that class name is stored in that array index position 0. So what this class dot for name will do? Whatever the class name we dynamically supplied, it verifies whether that class is loaded in the memory or not. If it not yet loaded, it loads the class into the memory. Whenever your class is loaded into the memory, at that moment your static block is also executed. So just to confirm that whether your class is loaded in the memory or not, for that purpose I given the simple static block. You know, static block is executed only one time in the entire execution of a program. So that means whenever your class is loaded into the memory, at that moment only your static block is also executed. Now similarly, if I say like Java space test B, now I passed B's class. Now how many command line arguments you have seen at this moment? Only one. So again JVM creates a single dimensional array for the string with a size as 1 because you passed only one value. So now what happens here? Your B's class is loaded into the memory, B static block. Now again see Java space test sample. Now here I supplied one name as sample. This name with a class is not available, sample class is not yet available, then at this moment we'll get an exception. Java.lang.class not found exception sample. Who raises this exception? Class dot for name only. But what we are saying here, whenever the exception is occurred, any kind of exception, we are not interested to handle this exception. Simply we are forwarding this exception to the caller, that is JVM, because main method is called by the JVM only. So that's why your exceptions are also forwarded by to the JVM internally. So that is the meaning here. Class not found exception is occurred whenever if your supplied class name is invalid, if it not yet available, then we'll get that exception. So just this simple example shows that how to use the class dot for name for loading a class into the memory. That is a point to understand simply. Suppose see here I am putting this line number 17 in the comment. Now see, instead of from the command line argument, I can say class dot for name of A. Again see, class dot for name of A. Now if you observe here, here I am writing the same statement multiple times, more than one time. Class dot for name of A, again class dot for name of A. So what is the meaning of this statement at this time? In the first statement, in the line number 18, here we passed the class name here only. Statically we passed it. Okay, this we can say it as a static loading. Anyway, you passed the class name here only. But this is dynamic loading, earlier what we seen. Now what this class.forName will do, same story. It verifies whether your class is loaded in the memory or not. If it not yet loaded, it loads into the memory. It loads your class into the memory. That is the point. Then coming to the point, to the second statement, class.forName of A again. What happens in this statement? It verifies your A's class is loaded in the memory or not. Yes, it's loaded. It's already loaded. So it doesn't load again. So this statement is ignored. So that means if I run this program right now here, so how many static blocks are executed? Only one block at this moment. Compiling the program, test. So you can see your A static block is executed only one time. This second statement is ignored. It doesn't load again because your class is already loaded in the memory. So this is the basic fundamental point, first of all, what you need to understand about the static block concept. Not only that, how to load the class into the memory using class.forName statement. So when the exception is occurred, class not found exception, you understand very clearly here. So now in this today's session, we are going to discuss about another important point called the driver manager internal story about that. If you see the second point here, registering the driver with the driver manager. What happens at the time of registering the driver with the driver manager? First of all, what is a driver manager actually? Driver manager is a singleton class. So what do you mean by the singleton? Singleton means a class which contains only one object. A class which contains only one object. Such type of class is a singleton class. So singleton class can't be extended. You can't extend a singleton class. So singleton class means a class which contains only one object, and this object is also created by the same class member. So you can't extend the driver manager class. Driver manager is a singleton class. You are not allowed to extend this class. You are not allowed to create an object for this class also. That means I can't say driver manager OB is equals to new driver manager. So because it's a singleton, whenever the class is singleton, you are not allowed to extend this class. You are not allowed to create an object for this class. This class object is created at the time of loading the class only. Whenever your class is loaded into the memory, at that moment only your class object is also created. That is a singleton class concept. Why the driver manager is defined as a singleton class? What is the reason behind that? The reason is, we'll tell you diagrammatically today. Just please concentrate on this. Driver manager class, why it is singleton? Means whenever driver manager class is loaded into the memory first time, at that moment only driver manager object is also created. That is the concept of singleton. So how many times the driver manager object is created? Means only one time. Whenever your class is loaded into the memory, at that moment only this object is also created. Whenever this object is created, internally this object contains a driver pool. What do you mean by driver pool exactly? driver pool means it is a single dimensional array which contains your registered driver's information. Driver pool means this driver pool is nothing but it is a single dimensional array which contains your driver's information, your registered driver's information. So, every driver information means the driver object address is stored in this array. How many times this array is created? This array is created only one time for the entire project, because the driver manager object is created only one time. At the time of creating the driver manager object, internally your array is also created. This is known as driver pool, because it contains driver's information. So, every driver object address is internally stored in this array only. This is known as registering a driver with driver manager. So, in order to maintain this array only one time for the entire project, that is one of the reason for making the classes singleton. Suppose, let's assume if driver manager class is not declared as singleton, what is the problem? I will tell you. Everyone can extend a driver manager class. Everyone can create an object to driver manager class. At that moment, a new array is created every time whenever the object is created. So, at that time, maintaining multiple drivers information is completely difficult to the programmer. Suppose if I have a 3-4 driver manager object, every driver manager object is having its own array. So, there is no common collection. We have a different arrays. So, identifying or maintaining the drivers are very difficult. That's why they define the class as singleton. So, what happens at that moment? So, whenever the class is defined as singleton, you are not allowed to create an object to that class. That class object is created itself only whenever that class is loaded into the memory. At that moment only, your driver pool is also created. So, that is the point what you need to understand here. Second reason is, whenever the driver manager object is created only one time, this object multiple threads can access. That means, whenever multiple threads can access at a time means a thread can register the driver, a thread can deregister the driver, a thread can request the driver for connection, lot of operations. So, all these threads are accessing the same driver manager object, one are to be same. So, at that moment what happens here? We are allowing only one thread at a time to access, and remaining other threads are placed in the waiting room. So, for thread safety point of view also, we are using this driver manager object as singleton. So, whenever if multiple threads are accessing this object, allowing only one thread to perform operations at a time, and remaining other threads are in the waiting room. For that reason, the driver manager object is singleton. So, that is the point what you need to understand here. Why driver manager is a singleton class? How the registering happens internally with the driver? This is what an explanation to understand about the point clearly. And in the next coming session, we are going to discuss about how to perform the operations programmatically, how to load the driver. That we'll see with one simple example program, and later on we'll see some more internal points about that. Okay, that's all for the today's session. Thank you.